not allowed.
Me, 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 me.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Bum, 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 bum.
SJ is a Filipino woman, 37 years of age, presenting to her primary care physician with the complaints of excessive urination, increased thirst, fatigue, and excessive sweating. She has been experiencing these conditions for the last month. She is 5 feet 3 inch tall and weighs 145 pounds. Her calculated BMI is 25.7 kilogram per squared meter. She admits to a generally sedentary occupation and lifestyle. She confirms a family history of diabetes on her mother's side. According to the reported symptoms, the patient's blood glucose level was monitored. At that time, the patient's random blood glucose level was 210 milligrams per deciliter, which was beyond the normal range of the random blood glucose level of less than 140 milligrams per deciliter. Patient was also said to monitor her fasting glucose level that was 134 milligrams per deciliter, which was also beyond the normal range of 70 to 100 milligrams per deciliter. Further laboratory tests were done, and she was diagnosed with diabetes mellitus type 2. The doctor prescribed metformin hydrochloride 500 milligrams twice a day as a first-line therapy. The diabetes diagnosis requires education, so that the patient will have a longer, healthier life with fewer complications. The goal of this video is to provide important information about diabetes management through counseling of patients with type 2 DM.
Good day, ma'am. I'm Krisha, your pharmacist for today. How can I help you?
Hi, I have a question about this prescription.
Are you Miss SJ, and is this medication for you?
Yes, it's a newly prescribed medication by my doctor.
Ah, yes, ma'am. The medication prescribed for you is metformin 500 milligrams. It's a medication for your diabetes, which is used to control your high blood sugar levels and help manage your weight. For metformin, you should take it at the same time each day. Since it should be taken 2 times a day, take 1 tablet in the morning right after breakfast and then the other 1 tablet at night after dinner. Remember, you should always eat your meal before taking metformin to prevent a low blood sugar episode, which can also be dangerous. It's important to maintain your blood levels at the right range. You are prescribed metformin for 1 month, and then after finishing the 1 month, you should follow up with your physician to see if the drug therapy is effective for you. Are you currently taking any other medications aside from this?
No, not really, just that one. The doctor said I have type 2 diabetes. Is there any way I could manage my sugar level more?
Do you smoke or drink alcohol?
No, but I like drinking instant coffee and eating sweets such as chocolates.
For the lifestyle change, a balanced diet is recommended. You should regulate your carbohydrate, sugar, and salt intake. Spread out your carbohydrate consumption, which should be half of your total caloric intake throughout the day. It is also advisable to minimize eating chocolate, and you can make your own coffee to control the sugar content. Aerobic exercise, like walking 30 minutes a day, 3 times a week, is also helpful to manage your weight and improve blood sugar.
Oh, okay. Thank you for this. It will be a great help.
May I also ask if you have a glucometer at home to monitor your blood sugar levels?
Yes, my doctor also showed me how to use it.
That's good. Can you show me how you use it?
Sure, good thing I have my glucometer here. So first, I'll set out the glucometer, a test strip, and a lancet, and also an alcohol prep pad. it is important to wash hands first to prevent infection, or it's just okay to use alcohol instead. So I'll turn on the glucometer and place the test strip in the machine when it is ready. Watch the indicator for placing the blood on the strip. Then I should also dry my hands and wipe the area I've selected with an alcohol prep pad and wait until the alcohol evaporates. Then I will pierce my fingertip on the side of it between the bottom of my fingernail to the tip of my nail. Then I will place the drop of blood on or at the side of the strip. Then wait for the glucometer to calculate the blood sugar reading. Then after that, I'll write down the results and record them.
It's good that you know how to properly use it. Frequent use of glucometer can help you check how controlled your blood sugar is and whether it's high or low. Recognizes patterns when you're more likely to have a spike or crash in glucose. See how your glucose levels respond after exercise or in times of stress. It can also monitor the effects of diabetes medications and other therapies. The ranges for your blood sugar levels varies depending on the situation. The normal levels for FDS should be less than 100 milligrams per deciliter, while for after meals, less than 180 milligrams per deciliter. When you have low blood sugar, you might feel faint, and it's important that you also manage this. Eat or drink something that is sweet, like 1 tablespoon of sugar and candy, and then check your blood sugar levels after 15 minutes.
Oh, this information is very helpful. Thank you for this.
You're welcome, ma'am. Can I ask for you to repeat the important information about your medication?
Sure. So first, I should take my medication, which is metformin 500 milligram regularly twice a day after breakfast and dinner. Then I should also limit my carbohydrate and sugar intake, and then do exercise at least 3 times a week as much as possible.
Very well, ma'am. Are there any more I can help you with?
No, not really. I think everything is already fine. Thank you so much.
Okay, ma'am. But if in case you have more questions, don't hesitate to call me or any of my colleagues again. Thank you and stay safe.